Hello fighter fans, this is Prime 92, and today I'll be looking at the 160 scale Astray Red Frame Fighter. This is from the Deban company, and I got this from Gundam Central. So, it's a knockoff of the Perfect Grade Red Frame, and it's not too bad. In short, it does have issues. I'm not gonna lie about that. But it's actually pretty good. The plastic quality is pretty much Bandai quality. I don't see really any problem there. You got the clear pieces, which, the ones on the head, if I actually angle the camera, the ones on the head here are a little, they come out a little too easily for my taste. And, the V-fin, you know what, the V-fin on, the only one that is a real grade that has no problem with the V-fin actually locks in place. Every other one I have is a pain in the ass. With the asteroids. I still understand the clear green on the body. Like, it has it on the backpack, on the legs, and on the side of the head. Now, I understand the eyes and the forehead, but not down there. Just some like, symmetry? I don't know. Let's take a look at the actual head. It does look really nice. Got the clear in there, which you, it does come with foil stickers to go, black ones to go around the eyes, and, the green for the forehead. But they suck. And I figure they suck, because they usually do. I tried to put them on, they wouldn't even adhere. So, it's just the clear green, which is fine. Now, you do get an LED for the eyes, which you have to put together, and it does work. Well, it was working. Did I leave it on? Well, it's working. It's dim, but it will work. You can see, yeah, it's not that bright. You actually get two batteries, so maybe the battery's low. Now, the thing is, I had it in, it works, but the thing is, as soon as I put the head, all, like, the back of the head together, because you have to take off the back of the head here in order to get that in, and as soon as I did that and close it up, it like, triggers it again, it, like, hits the switch just enough to turn it back on. So it would literally be on all the time if I had it in the head. So, and it's a little pain in the butt to get the head apart to do that, so it's not a big deal, I don't think. Now, you do have some other stickers, marking stickers here, with that yucky yellow background. But it is pretty crisp detail. They probably wouldn't stick to save their lives. But you also have some water slide, or not water slide, a rope transfer, which are pretty good looking. They might stay on, I'm hoping. I don't know, but they might. And he also came with rubber pads for the bottom of the feet, and they wouldn't stay on either. They almost did, but not quite. I actually had to take off this one. I tried this one. That's why it's got all this gunk on the bottom. It's from the adhesive sticking on, but not good enough. I just left it off that one. But yeah, it goes into the divots. So it'd be good for traction, if they stuck. I'm sure the real one does. But not on the knockoff. But it does have nice detail all over it. You can see the, I see the spine there. It does have two tones of red. Very nice. It stands perfectly fine. It actually stands better than my, a real Perfect Grade Strike, which is a little sad. Although, it does have all the, like, Perfect Packs on, so I guess that's probably the reason. Now, when it comes to articulation, this is where it starts to fall apart, literally. So let me get the camera up here. Now you have the head, which is fine. It's got a ball joint. And it's also got a joint. Oopsie, there goes that V-fin. But it's also got a joint in the neck a little bit. A little, moves a little bit forward and back. So that's fine. Yeah, that V-fin. But I, like I said, even the Master Grade has its problem with the V-fin coming off. The arms. Well, they do rotate, and then they do that. Yeah, you see, the polycaps. This is something I was worried about, because a lot of knockoffs do this, and third-party ones have this problem. They can't get the actual polycaps down properly. They just can't. It's a thing that they just haven't been able to figure out. Some have, But at least this one, this could be an older demand kit. I have no idea. I'm not really sure when it was released. But it does not cooperate with the polycaps. So, it will stay on, but as soon as you start to move it. Now, this one here, I took just some masking tape, and I wrapped it around the peg, thickened it up some. And now, it stays on. It's a little tight, but I could have loosened it up some, taken some tape off, but it's fine. You got the forward and backward at the torso, some up and down, just like a master grade. And the arms can go out and rotate. It's also a little, it also comes off a little too easily here, so I put some tape on there too. Got a double jointed elbow. But they also have the, it's not the wrist, it's like halfway up. Same thing as the strike, it bends. And then you have the ball jointed wrist, whoops. The ball jointed wrist, which also has a hinge. And then the fully articulated fingers, which work perfectly fine. I have had no problems with them popping out. So they're good. You have these, well, it kind of goes side to side a little bit on the stomach. I feel it's supposed to, but it doesn't do that much. And you do have a swivel at the waist. The waist is also a problem. It does come off a little too easily. So you gotta kind of force it, like hold it down when you rotate it, or it pops off. There's also the skirts, which are, I think the master grade does this too, where it's a bar from the back to the front. And so this whole thing moves together. And these side skirts are ball jointed, but they're very close to everything, so you can't really use them that much. The white part here is actually hinged, like jointed, ball jointed. And then the red part is hinged. It's really weird. It's not together. And then the back skirts are also ball jointed, so you can get them out of the way. And this part is hinged. The legs, there is a die-cast chunk, is the actual crotch connector in the middle is die-cast. And it will let the leg go forward about that far. And then backward. And the legs start to come off because it also has a problem with the polycap. When it goes back that far. Out that far. Pretty good. See, it does support the weight. It's not going to fall off if you don't move it. It rotates some at the hip. You have a... that skirt. I messed up the skirt. It was weird. I tried to put it on that side, and for some reason, this side was... this ball joint is looser than that one. So if I hadn't put this one over there, it'd be fine, but I stressed the, I stretched out the ball, so... oh well. Got a double jointed knee, which is very nice. Look at all that... all that paneling. Very cool. And then the, this is really cool too. I think the strike does it, but it has side to side of the ankle, and when you move it, these panels move at the same time. Very cool. I really like it. And then you have the ball joint and the ankle, which you have the hydraulics you can see in there. So you get the forward and back, some side to side. And then the toes can go up pretty far, and down. So pretty good articulation. Oh, I also almost forgot. There's also a little piece here. You can bring it down. And then, oops, that, what did I do? You bring it down. Oh, okay, well this is easier. But it comes down, and then you can bring the whole thing forward, and then lock that in place again. Now, this leg isn't coming off because I did something different. I tried two different things. I used masking tape on the arm, and then on this leg, I switched the polycap from my Perfect Grade Strike with this guy, and so he's using the normal Perfect Grade polycap, and it works perfectly. So, it's definitely the polycap. It's not the actual mold. But the funny thing is, I did put the knockoff polycap in my Perfect Grade Strike, and it's fine. You wouldn't even know that it has a knockoff polycap inside. It holds perfectly fine, just like the other leg. So something's weird. It's strange. Oh, and I should mention, the And inside the plastic here in the knee is also die cast, so you do have some weight to the kit. So, yeah, I'm considering putting the other polycaptan strike in here if the other one's perfectly fine. Why not? Because I have, like, the strike is, it still has the other equipment on, and it's, the feet are giving out, but the legs aren't. So I might switch them up. Maybe. And I'll probably put the masking tape on this arm. I might try it on the leg too, just to see. But yeah, once I get it in there, it'll stay. It's just trying to move it. And you do have an opening cockpit. Just gotta move this part. Hey, they tell you to move this part down in the instructions, but I always have a hard time moving it down. It doesn't want to move. So I have to just kind of force this out and then extend the on the track. And you can kind of see in there, can't remember his name, Low, I think it is. And you're just sitting there. There's a little panel in there, a display. So yeah, it's pretty cool. I do like that. So that's pretty much the body. But of course we have the accessories, so let's go on the back here and get the beam saber handles, which is pegged. I would have expected there'd be like a cover here to make this a little more solid, but it's just a big empty space. And there goes the waste. Yeah, because all the metal's in here, and so it does. If you're holding him in at an angle, there's a chance he'll fall apart. So we've got the, oopsie, sorry, the really cool beam sabers, or beams. I like them. They're sparkly pink. And they're custom just for the Astrae because they only have these, like, really jagged edges. Well, usually. And just gotta force it a little bit in there, but there we go. It does have the hole all the way through, so you can put it in either hand. And the pegs are also very good. Very good. So just gotta peg it in there. Find the friggin' peg. That'd be helpful, wouldn't it? Find your peg. And there we go. Not even gonna have the fingers wrap around, as you can see. No problem. Holds it just fine. And that's good. That is good. And we have the beam rifle, which has a clear green piece for the scope. You got a movable handle here. Is this like a rocket or a missile or something? Because it does detach, and it kind of looks like it. I never really saw this before, so I don't know. But it's there, and it also has a peg, but only on the, it's only got the hole on the one side, so it has to be in the right hand. But once you find the peg, why am I having such a hard time with this? Shouldn't be this hard, but oh yeah, I guess I should put his finger in there. That would probably help. There we go. Holds just fine. So that's good. And then finally, we have the, oh, not finally. What am I thinking? We have the shield, which is just the mostly the strike shield. But yeah, in the Astrae colors, you have the handle you can hold that is on a hinge and can go down and up on a truck. You have the blast shield cover. You got the connector here you can rotate. You can have it in like this. And then you can have it underneath the arm, but the way I like it is to rotate that around and then peg it. Now this is interesting. They actually have a cover. It's on a double hinge and it moves up, and then you expose the hole that's on the arm, yeah, on the inner frame. Problem with this guy, the hinges were too tight and they broke on that arm. And then I'm like, well, I think this one was loose, so I moved it without making the hole bigger, and it broke. So if you do get the knockoff, just make those holes on the hinges a little bigger that go into the white part here, and it should be fine. But yeah, don't be stupid like me. But they actually hold with friction, so I was gonna glue them, but they hold, so whatever. But you just, peg it. Well, they hold if you don't mess it. You can see where it broke right there. But just, peg it in there. Oh, and there's a little flap here to give when you straighten up the arm. Yeah, for you. It is on the arm. And looking pretty good. And now, finally, is the best thing of the Astray Red Frame. And that is the Gabura Straight, I believe it's called. Pretty big katana with the sheath. Really nice looking. Got the nice metallic chrome gold on the sheath here on the hilt. And it's got a cool, like a lion face on there. You can see it. Very neat. Has a little teeny gold piece that goes through here. I don't know why, but it's there. I'm sure someone could tell me why, what significance that is. Has two holes, so you can have them in both hands, which is good. And it does lock pretty well in here, and then you just slide it, and it's a fingerprint magnet, I gotta say. But yeah. It's all chrome silver. And the cool thing is, there's two holes, if you notice, on the sheath. So you can actually have the sheath pegged into the hand. And have the katana in the other hand. And I've actually done that. There we go. So you just do that. And it's on the ground. And it's holding it. So that's cool. Yeah. Gotta put some tape on those. Well, since his arm's off, let's do it like this. So yeah, you can have him hold it in the hand too with the katana. There you go. Perfectly fine. He's been disarmed. Yeah! So, that is... Oh, you stay. Actually, I'm gonna keep his arm off. Make this easier. So that's the normal stuff that you can have him hold the sheath in the hand, but why would you when you have this cool thing? Now this is basically to mount the sheath on the side skirt. You have a hinge here, which will... I really like this. It's actually a little trap door that they have on here. You just flip those panels up, and then you can just peg it onto the side. And you also have a little hinge here. It unlocks. It's actually locked. Like that. So, you can keep it like that, and close here. Or, there's two hinges here. You open them up. And now, there's little teeth that will peg into here. There's a little hole here for that tooth. And then there's a hole up here for the tab right here. Just kind of open it up. And then match up the holes. And... like that. Nice and solid. Well, push it a little farther. There we go. So yeah, that was on the side skirt. Straighten that up. There. And we put the katana in, just for a little added security to make sure that it stays in the sheath. This little part goes down over the hilt. Just a little bit. Maybe it should go a little further. But that's as far as it goes in mine, anyways. And there it is. Let me get this arm back on. Get him looking proper. And that shoulder. I guess I should glue these on. But I mean, if I decide to paint it, that would be a pain in the butt to get apart. So why not? Alright, so. That is everything you get with the perfect grade Astray Fighter. Brr. But, as I mentioned before, I got this guy for a reason. And that reason is the Tactical Arms 160 third-party kit, which is just an upgrade of the, like, upscale of the Mastery. Now, okay, that's stale. I think this is the Delta Formation, the way it is here. So, with this, you do have to make some modifications. You have to take off the backpack, which pegs right in there where the striker pack would go. And you have to pull out this. So this thing is off to the side now. Which isn't a big deal, really. And then the sword, the tactical arms, came with this. Which I was jamming into the strike, because there's some stress marks there, because it's not made for it, really. But you put that into the poly cap. That arm. Make sure you do it kind of like at an angle, because the polycap will sink into the body a little bit and make it really hard, so just try. You're gonna be like that, aren't you? Don't be like that, man. There's no reason. There. And then just peg that into the back cavity. Like that. Now it's nice and secure. Oh, just the shield that came off. I thought it was the arm. Okay, well, we're good. Alright, so, now you just have to take the backpack, the pedicle arm, which has a hole there, and slot it in, and you're done. And he's back heavy, because this thing's kind of heavy. Just make sure the feet are all... Actually, did I lock those hips in there? Let me see. There we go. That might help some. So, that... Ugh, he is really back heavy. Not much I can do about that. Yeah, okay, let's see if I can get that in a little better. Yeah, I'm not sure if I messed that connector up by having it in the strike all this time. But, anywho, there it is. Put his katana back on. Get in there. And that is the perfect grade Astray fighter with the tactical arms mounted on it. I really gotta lean him forward to get him not to fall over. And I was talking about the strike before. There we go. Okay, so leaning forward is a good thing. But yeah, that is actually a pretty heavy backpack. I'm not even sure if the real one would be able to work with that. But it's pretty cool. I really like it. I just gotta fight with it a bit and get it into the proper position so it doesn't fall off the shelf when I get it up there. So, oh god, this is gonna be something. Let's lean you back against the background. Because I'm gonna try and show you with the perfect, great, perfect strike. God almighty, help me. This is a lot of perfectness on one area. Oh god. No, okay, that actually worked. Swords can touch. Alright. There we go. Yeah, that's actually pretty cool. They'll be side by side on the shelf. That'll look nice. So, I'm just going to leave the strike on there. That is the perfect grade Astray fighter. It has issues. It is a knockoff. It usually does. Like, it's hard to get around, like, get something, especially a perfect grade, and have no issues, and it seems to be stemming from the polycaps. There were a few parts that were a little too tight and they broke. I mentioned mostly the elbow pieces. Everything else, I don't think anything else broke. And, it's just the polycaps, really. I don't know, they didn't get them right. Maybe they figure out how to fix that in later models they've done. Maybe I got duds, because I know that the normal strike has no problem, so, with the polycaps in here. So, the actual plastic's good, it's sound. But yeah, connecting them is a little tricky. So if you try to move them, like I've done, either put some tape on the pegs or switch out the polycaps. But, I mean, I only want it for the tactical arm, so I'm fine with this. So if you want to pick it up, click the link below to go to Gundam Central, and I'll see you in the next review.